Hey everybody, it's Dan Harris. Thanks for checking out our video series. Today we're going to be talking about my top five player props for week 9 of the 2021 NFL season. All right, let's start with Devontae Parker going over his receiving prop of 56.5 receiving yards. Now the Texans allow an average of 266 yards passing to opposing quarterbacks, and those yards are likely going to be split here primarily between Parker, Jalen Waddle, and Mike Gesicki, but it's Parker who's probably going to pile on the yards for a few reasons. First, his average depth of target is 11.9 yards, so he is being targeted down the field when he does see the ball, and he sees the ball pretty often. No fewer than 7 targets in any game that he's played. Also, his matchup is pristine. The Texans are actually decent against slot wide receivers, but they really struggle to contain perimeter receivers like Parker. Both Vernon Hargraves and Terrence Mitchell have been terrible in coverage, and this is a game where Tua Tagovailoa is going to want to prove himself with all the drama that has been surrounding Deshaun Watson. Parker is going to sail over this prop so long as he avoids injury. Next up, let's talk about Matt Ryan and going under his passing yards prop of 256.5 yards. And we took the under on Matt Ryan's passing yards prop last week, and we easily cleared it, and we should again here too as he takes on the Saints. First, as of this recording, I don't expect Calvin Ridley to play after he stepped away from football last week. He obviously could come back at any time, but there's nothing to suggest that it's going to be this week. That's just a huge blow to Matt Ryan's projected passing yards. Kyle Pitts is great, Cordarrelle Patterson finds a way to produce, but I mean, we're talking about Russell Gage, Tajae Sharpe, Olamide Zaccheaus. This is just not a lineup anymore that lends itself to big passing days. I know Tom Brady just threw for a ton of yards against the Saints, but they're 5th in defensive DVOA against the pass. They're healthy on defense, and Taysom Hill is going to be starting for them. So the Saints are already the most run-heavy team in the league at 52%, but they're about to get even more run-heavy with Hill under center. And here's the thing, the Saints are a slightly slower team than average in pace of play in a neutral game script, but when they're ahead by a touchdown or more, they're 29th in pace of play, and they are favored here by nearly a touchdown. The clock is going to run, they're going to be long drives by the Saints, it's going to lead to fewer opportunities for Matt Ryan and the Falcons. He's going to have a hard time hitting this prop, so go with the under. All right, next up, let's talk about Mike Williams and going under his receiving yard prop of 55.5 yards. The Eagles have some issues, but their defense has been better than expected, and they're particularly good at limiting the production of wide receivers. In fact, only 3 wide receivers have topped 66 yards receiving against them, and they were Deebo Samuel, Tyreek Hill, and Antonio Brown. They are particularly stout against perimeter wide receivers, and especially the top perimeter wide receiver, because Darius Slay has been outstanding in coverage, and he usually shadows. The Eagles have played 8 games. Slay has allowed just 187 yards total in his coverage this entire season. That's on 39 targets. And Williams has 27 yards receiving or fewer in 3 of his last 4 games. He is always a threat to explode because, you know, he's Mike Williams, but the odds are against it here in a tough matchup. Take the under on his receiving yards prop. Next up, let's go with Emmanuel Sanders going over 53.5 receiving yards. Taking the over on a receiving yard prop for a receiver who just got shut out is a little dicey, but I'm not too concerned here. First, the fact that the Bills should destroy the Jaguars should not worry you about them turning to the run early and not throwing or anything like that. That's just not how the Bills operate of late, and even if they did, Josh Allen can throw for 300 yards on 15 pass attempts if need be, like he did against the Chiefs. But this is a particularly good matchup for Sanders. Put aside that Dawson Knox may still miss this game and Cole Beasley is banged up, the Jaguars are just really, really bad against wide receivers. They have one sort of bright spot, and it's Shaquille Griffin, but he shadows the opposing team's number one wide receiver, and that's obviously going to be Stephon Diggs. That leaves the rookie Tyson Campbell to get Sanders. Out of 705 defensive players who are graded in coverage, Campbell is 613th. He allowed a 78.1% catch rate this year and 16.5 yards per reception. Josh Allen knows how to attack a defense, and Campbell is a weak spot. Expect Sanders to rebound from his poor performance here and put up a nice game. finally, let's go with Ben Roethlisberger under 246.5 passing yards. This game just does not set up like a big passing game for Big Ben. The Bears are a lot easier to run against than pass against. They're 13th in defensive DVOA against the pass, but just 24th against the run. Chicago has held 5 of 8 quarterbacks under this number, and they include Joe Burrow, Tom Brady, Aaron Rodgers, Derek Carr, and Baker Mayfield. The Steelers probably aren't going to need a ton of points here, but they should be content to rely on their defense. 246 isn't a huge number, and Ben has cleared it in 4 of his 7 games, but he has been absolutely terrible pushing the ball down the field. He's one of the worst deep passers in the league, so it's going to be a lot of dink and dunk. Now, both teams are slow. The Bears rank 27th, the Steelers 21st in average pace of play. Strikes me as a boring game here with a lot of runs where the clock moves and the under probably hits. And that leads to an under on Roethlisberger's passing yards total, more than likely. And that's going to do it for my top 5 player props for week 9 of the 2021 NFL season. Thanks for checking out our video series as always, and don't forget to subscribe here at youtube.com/bettingpros so you don't miss any of the great content we're going to continue to put out all season long.